At this point, we have our classes, our attributes. What we're missing is the operations for the class. Let me remind you that operations represent the behavior of a class and that they might be found by examining interactions among entities in the description of my system. So once more, let's bring back our description. And let's, in this case, focus on this specific item that says that the students might use the system to add courses. So this is clearly indicating an action that the students should be able to perform. But notice that this doesn't mean that this is an operation that should be provided by the student's class. It rather means that there should be somewhere in the system the possibility of performing this operation. So let's see what this means for our example. This might mean, for example, if we focus on the registration manager, so that there should be an operation in the registration manager that allows me to add a student to a course. And this in turn means that both course and course offering should provide a way to add a student. And therefore, I add this corresponding operation to the registration manager, to the course, and to the course offering. So after doing that, we will continue and populate in a similar way the other classes in the system. So let me recap. Now we saw how to identify classes, how to identify members of the classes, in particular attributes and operations. There is one thing that we're missing, a very important aspect of the class diagram, which is the relationships between these classes.